Lorenzo came out and he said something about Fresh Kid. He goes like, yo, this boy can actually balance education and his talent. I mean, why do people think that education is the mark for success? Look at me. I'm successful. And then the conversation went into overdrive. We're asking, so is it right for us to use Eddie Kenzo's level of success as a pedestal for Fresh Kid, or a pedestal for just plain I am a success? Perfect example is Eddie Kenzo, right? Or can we take it that Eddie Kenzo is confusing success with luck and effort and hard work put in and the right type of friends? Now, as for the education bit, I cannot, because when I looked at the whole Fresh Kid situation, there was a bunch of people who are like, you know what, just being logical as parents who are trying to support a child, probably he could do both. And then there was a sect of people who are actually like, what is education? We have seen rich people who have not got education. He can actually also go and make money. I'm like, now that group is the group that never made it far in school. And they're trying to justify their shortcomings. Now, we get all of that up. Shake it up, stir it up good, and we put it in one catchy like this, ba ba ba. What should we say about Fresh Kid? Is he a success? Not yet. He isn't on his way to success. Is what Eddie Kenzo said, should we use Eddie Kenzo as a pedestal to look at success? No. Does he need education more than he needs talent? In my own opinion, yes. Because never to nagamba mbutu ongerenga balia woku street ya bomu chibala abachikana gamba wa abagaga jebalia wabatamanyi na luzungu mwana tebaso mana eva inebi zimbe. That is what Farouk is saying. Farouk is like, yo, oba toina bizimbe Kampala, nga toina bank charges, oba bank balance, tosini kabinyo, you are not successful. But then you're confusing success and fame. Being famous doesn't mean you're successful. And being famous doesn't mean you're rich. You can be rich and famous, but you can actually be famous and not rich. But one thing that will stay a constant, if you ask me, is if you have the knowledge. Why do you think the white man took away the books from the black person? Because they know. Information is power. Knowledge is power. The moment you decide to get back to the back of your brain and decide to get into the knowledgeable bit of your brain, you have conquered pretty much it all. That's why you see bakugamba. Omusajja omugagga aina knowledge. Nebwazi mumalako zonna mpaka to the last drop. The fact that he has an education or some bit of knowledge about what he is getting into, he will build it back from the ground up. Now, the whole thing is like, I'm stepping on toes. I'm also seated on fences with this. But let's face it, if you have an education, you have a plan B, you have a fallback on. Katulaba, amantunga chameleon. I'm not being disrespectful, because chameleon laid his education down so that his brothers could get something for themselves. And he did quite good at that, right? But he didn't get an education. If Chameleon had gotten that type of education that we expect, that he was supposed to get in that time, I don't think he would be holding on tight to the music that much, even when he knows it's flitting by. I don't think we would actually be ridiculing the fact that he wants to join politics. The reason why Bobby Wine decided to go to Harvard and do that short stint, that is him trying to get knowledge. The reason why Bobby Wine gets all these books and tries to educate himself and find out what exactly is the world all about, is because he knows at the end of the day, he can fall back on that. It never goes to waste. Knowledge never goes to waste. Now, as in regards to Fresh Kid's talent, when this voice breaks, I don't think the talent will be so there, but we'll wait. Not that, but as a nation, it's sad that we stood there, watched two adult, able-bodied parents stand on national television and tell us we cannot let our child go to school because he has to look after us. That's on us. It's not on that seven-year-old boy. If that boy ever grows up and he has issues in life, I want each and every Ugandan to sit back and understand you played a part in that. You played a part in whatever will befall him because you have let it come to pass. You have let it be. The conversation, education, Kenyina Agamba, education is not the marker for success. Omwana wali kusomero. Atula na yena akola na yo homework. You think Maya is not like Northwest? Northwest is always doing the Sunday service with her dad. You know? They have talent. Chiba Musai. If your father was a runner, at some point one of his kids would be a runner. But Eddie Kenzo, who is saying that, has never really exposed his kids like that. He actually never exposes his kids like that. But he's saying it's okay. He can balance books and education. At the age of 7, have you met a 7-year-old brain? Like, I don't know about this whole fresh kid situation, but I am forced to talk about it because it's what keeps going on in people's mouths. I remember I was actually watching Dave Chappelle, and Dave Chappelle made some quite... it opened up my eyes when it comes to this whole success and education talk, you know? Dave Chappelle was like, there is a reason why they handed us the balls to be athletes. They made us athletes, they made us all these beautiful things. And the smart few in us, got the education. It was better for the white person to make you an athlete because you're going to get so much money, but you're never going to do much with it. Now, if you look at the American problem, that's the same problem we have in Africa. Half of the reasons why we are the way we are as an African country is because of an educational problem. Half of the reason why we make the decisions we make as a nation is because, same thing, like, when someone opens up your mind, that is the best gift they can ever give you. There is more money in your mind than any money you can make out there. The white man took away the books, nagamba money, ebitabo mulabisa okubeera nnyo ab'amagezi katubajjako ebitabo tubawe talent. And that's what we run with. And look at where we are. We're still fighting as a minority, not just in Uganda, everywhere. So guys, when they say stay woke, in church, it's a miracle. Staying woke is not about knowing the white man don't love you or it's racist or what. No, this is not racial. Me, when I tell someone to stay woke, I want you to stay woke with your mind. Your mind. Use your mind. Think. Logically think. Anyway, chokanchi veko. But it is Eddie Kenzo's day on school. But then today, no, gotcha, tomorrow, get a call. So don't think the talent is enough to propel you to greater heights alone. Talent can take you places that you have never imagined or envisioned to be at, but it's not going to keep you there. You need more. You compare whose music? Compare our Eddie Kenzo's music to Davido's music. Oh, child, I don't want to do that. Whiskey than Davido. Akalongo's South is all, yes.
Compare Baby Cool's music to Bobby Wine Kanye. Charing and all Baby Cool's music.
I know, right? Subliminal messages. The argument can go on and on, but on that note, someone hit me up on Instagram when Rema took to Instagram and posted photos of... I saw them on social media. They were having breakfast. Da, da, da. And then like a comment section, people are tagging me. Hey, Tina, you are saying this. Da, da, da. Bakubi, baka itapete mbu. Bakubi si za joke ane level. When my Rema showed them you're happy, hashtag, it's an ad, boo-boo. It's an ad. Chick is just trying to secure her bag. They securing their bag and you're here thinking, ooh, 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 life. Not that I'm saying they're not together, because she has not confirmed if they are not together or if they are together. But this goes back to the education thing. Because if you're educated and you take in these things slowly, you'll actually see them. I know it's so messy, man. Tuba so messy. Sometimes it's good to just have the banter, even if it's useless, even if it helps to see people's mindsets. It helps to know where everybody's coming from. And for me, it's an education. I like to take different things from all the conversations I have, even the commentary on YouTube, even the commentary on all the different social media platforms, because I feel I leave those platforms having learned a few things. So yeah, hit us up on the comment section on your take on all of this. Now, some of you decide to become and you get too intricate with details and facts. I don't want an Andrew Mwenda. I want layman terms where everybody else can read it and understand, put your point across, you know? That being said, at TinaVS1 is my Twitter handle, and on Facebook we are Scoop and Scoop and at TinaVS1. On Instagram, it's at TinaVS1 with an H on that. I'm out. I'll catch you again tomorrow. It's going to be a Wednesday. I hope there's fun stuff around to do. I'm out. Peace.